Now look, David Yeagley here, and in the process of campaigning for chairman of the Comanche Nation, probably I should identify myself a little bit more clearly for those who may decide to oppose me. I am a fifth generation direct descendant of Bad Eagle. I wanted to show some records here. Now, I have a file. I don't know if you can see this. These papers are, I think, some kind of Xerox copy in the style of 1,000 years ago. These are basically records from Fort Sill, the artillery museum. There's a lot of Indian records down at Fort Sill. Just to assure everyone of the existence of my ancestor, I don't know that you'll be able to see this, but I'm going to attempt to let you see there. Let's see, there is the name. If I could figure out how to. Bad Eagle, wait. Okay, if I go up, it goes down. If I go down, it goes up. Okay, Bad Eagle. So this way. Quinni Kichsuit. There it is, right there. Okay, also known as Gados. This is difficult. This is extremely difficult. I don't know how this camera works, but I'll just keep trying. Here is a page where you can see Gados was Cruz Portillo. Gados. And there is the wife, Erkze. Why doesn't this work? Erkze. And Obadiah. Bad Eagle, when he came back from Mexico, married two sisters, Erkze and Tonase. They were the daughters of horseback. Okay, I hope you can see that. When he, at the time these records were made, which is in the 1880s, I believe, perhaps later, 1890s, I will verify that. He was married to only one, that was Erkze. There's a whole story about Tonase, which I can tell later, but for now, I just want you to see that again. Gados is the same as Cruz Portillo. Cruz Portillo was the adopted Spanish name that was given to Quinni Kichsuit, Bad Eagle, when he was adopted, when he was captured as a young man. So he's already, we've got three names here we're working with already, and there are more. But the Comanches did not roll their R's like the Spanish. You say Cruz Portillo, the Comanches are going to say Gados Portillo. Gados, Gados, that's where the name K-O-D-O-S-E comes from. And that's the name that stuck. Because when the land allotments were handed out, his name is Gados. Gados got a land allotment. Erkze got an allotment. And Obadiah. They got three separate allotments. 509, 508, 510. And there was the records... vary, but my land, the land that our family derived, was through Obadiah. And that is 509 allotment. It's near Beaver Creek. And I have here a document from the Bureau of Indian Affairs, Anadarko office, which lists the different people that are on this land. There's some interesting names here. Comanche names, a lot of them are English, you know, English names. Like my name, Yeagley, is on there, and my sister and my brother, but names like Casanovoid, Comanches all know that one, Casanovoid, and the name Comachit. I'm not sure of the pronunciation on that, but there's several of them on here. And of course, my cousins, the Portillos, are on there. Now, there's Bad Eagle, and then Ygnacio, his son, which you can see right there, Ygnacio Portillo. That's Bad Eagle's son by the family he started in Mexico. Ygnacio had a son by the name of George, or Anacleto. And that is my grandfather. That is my mother's father, Anacleto. Now, I wanted to show you a record of his name as well. I thought I had that in front of me. These are very very difficult to read sometimes. Anacleto being his son, my goodness, means that my grandfather was on all three allotments. George, I have the records, which I perhaps I'll show in another video. His name was on three different land allotments, the one under Cados, the one under Erxe, and the one under Obadiah. But somehow, my mother's family, my mother's children, we're only on one of them. And I have yet to determine exactly how that came about. We're only on the one that is under Obadiah. But here's the name Anacleto Portillo. If I can hold this upright, I still don't know how this can get coordinated with this camera. Ah, there it is. Anacleto. Now you'll notice there's another Cruz Portillo. These are three children. Now, Anacleto is the only one that we have record evidence that he was the actual son of Ygnacio. Now, those two other children, Erlinda Portillo and another Cruz Portillo, came much later. This is a later record, and our family does not have the evidence that those other two children were actually children of Ygnacio. Now, we know that a man named Dave Cerde, whose real name was Satoro de la Cerda, a Mexican, he brought those children up from Mexico with a woman, and nobody knew who he was, nobody knew who those children were or who the woman was, but he claimed that they were children of Ygnacio. And it was accepted as such, but that's one of them they surname was calling Cruz Portillo. He's better known as Jack Portillo. This is Jack and Linda, for those Comanches that may know something about the family. So this is a little bit curious, because the direct line of Bad Eagle that we know of comes through George. Jack and Linda were, presented to the enrollment officers, the enrollment, the white people in charge of the tribe. These two children were presented as the children of Ygnacio without evidence or proof or identification of any kind that we have record of. So I would ask anybody in those, from those descendant of Jack or Linda, to please help us out here and identify that, because otherwise George is the only line, the direct line of Bad Eagle. There isn't any other. I'm running a little long here, but I'm going to go over this again in another video. This is very important as to who I am and why I feel free to campaign in Comanche land.